something again?
Well, I believe I have. The problem is, I can't remember what. Oh, well, I'm sure it'll come to me. Where are you off to?
To return this book to Père Robert. It's about two lovers in Fair Verona.
Sounds boring.
There she goes, let's go, it's strange, no question.
These are distracted, can't you tell?
Well, we were in business for ourselves, but now Schemer's joined us. He said we'll make a lot of money.
I don't like the sound of that.
But he's our partner.
Now let me see. That means he's one part, and you're another part. And if one part doesn't get along with another part, then you'll have to part. And if the two parts are apart, how can I tell you apart? Oh, this partnership business is very confusing. If things keep going like this, you'll end up like Donald and Douglas in the brake van.
Who are they?
You don't know the two Scottish twins, Donald and Douglas? Of course you don't know Donald and Douglas, because I haven't told you about Donald and Douglas. Or was it Douglas and Donald?
Do you have time to tell us a story? I mean, aren't you supposed to be running a race against the tortoise?
Don't worry about him. He probably isn't even to Point Pokey yet. Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Donald and Douglas.
Donald and Douglas are twins and had arrived from Scotland to help Sir Topham Hatt, but only one engine had been expected. The twins meant well, but did cause confusion. Sir Topham Hatt had given them numbers, Donald 9 and Douglas 10, but he was still planning to send one engine home. Yard that had taken a dislike to Douglas. Things always went wrong when he had to take it out. His trains were late and he was blamed. Douglas began to worry. Donald, his twin, was angry.
You can't, said the brake van. I am essential. Oh! Oh! Cried the van.
The van behaved better after that. Until one day, Donald had an accident. The rails were slippery. He couldn't stop in time. Donald wasn't hurt, but Sir Topham Hatt was most annoyed. I am disappointed, Donald. I didn't expect such clumsiness from you. I had decided to send Douglas back and keep you.
I'm sorry, sir, said Donald.
I should think so, too. You have upset my arrangements. Now, James will have to help with the goods work while you have your tender mended. James won't like that. Sir Topham Hatt was right. James grumbled dreadfully about extra work. Shut up, said James. It's not funny. He didn't like to be reminded of his own accident. James didn't say. He slouched sulkily away.
James is cross, snickered the spiteful brake van. We'll try to make him crosser still.
Hold back, giggled the freight cars to each other. James did his best, but he was exhausted when they reached Edward's station. Luckily, Douglas was there.
Help me up the hill, please, panted James. These freight cars are playing tricks.
Slowly but surely, the snorting engines forced the freight cars up the hill. But James was losing steam.
I can't do it! I can't do it!
Shouted Douglas. The conductor was anxious.
Go steady! The van's breaking!
The van was in pieces. No one had been hurt, and soon Edward came to clear the mess. Sir Topham Hatt was on board. I might have known it would be Douglas, he said. Douglas was grand, sir, said Edward. James had no steam left, but Douglas worked hard enough for three. I heard him from my yard. Two would have been enough, said Sir Topham Hatt. I want to be fair, Douglas, but I don't know. I really don't know. Sir Topham Hatt was making up his mind about which engine to send away, but that's another story. So, as Donald and Douglas learned, sometimes it's better to go about your business and not get sidetracked by the likes of a nasty brake van.
Who is beautiful as me, so I'm making plans to woo and marry Belle.